What's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another LaunchBox news video. Today, we're proud to announce LaunchBox for Android 1.15. So with this release, we've actually got some really awesome changes here, and I definitely want to go over most of the stuff that we have. But remember, we do have a changelog over on the website, so if you're interested in checking out all of the improvements, fixes, and new features, I'll leave a link for that in the description. Starting off here with the biggest new feature, Dolphin has been fully integrated with LaunchBox for Android, meaning when we import our games, we can actually automatically download the Dolphin emulator. We can also keep it up to date from the settings, and I'm going to go over this feature and show you exactly what I mean. It's actually really easy to get GameCube and Wii up and running now on your Android device with LaunchBox. What we're going to do here is import some GameCube games, and as you can see, I don't have any imported right now. We've made this really easy. So from the drop-down, we're going to import games. We're going to choose the folder we want to import our games from. I'm going to go to my internal storage, download. As you can see, I've got two separate folders here, Nintendo Wii, Nintendo GameCube. We'll start out with GameCube. Use this folder. Platform for imported games is set to Nintendo GameCube. Region to prioritize, I'm going with North America. Just take a look down the list. Everything's looking good over here. So we'll proceed with the import. It's going to give us a list of the games we're importing. Proceed. And now we've got our Nintendo GameCube section. Let's go ahead and do this for Wii real quick before we get into it. Drop down, import games, folder, go with Wii. So I've now got my Nintendo GameCube and Wii section right here, but I don't have the emulator downloaded. And that's where this new feature comes in really handy, because LaunchBox will automatically download it for us once we try to play a game. So I'm going to go with Automodelista, play. We recommend Dolphin as the best way to play Nintendo GameCube on your device. Dolphin does not appear to be installed, but we can automatically download and configure it for you. Would you like us to download and install it? I'll choose yes. We'll install. And now we're ready to start playing our GameCube games. Automodelista again, play. Since LaunchBox went through, downloaded, and configured the emulator for us, it's up and running, and I've got my on-screen touch controls going right now, but you can configure this for a physical controller. And that's it. We're now playing GameCube games because LaunchBox automatically went through, downloaded the emulator for us, and configured it. So yeah, now we've got our Nintendo GameCube games and our Wii games imported. LaunchBox automatically downloaded it for us, and it'll also keep it up to date. So from our drop-down, manage emulators, it's checking for updates across the board. LaunchBox for Android is managing RetroArch and Dolphin down here at the bottom. Looks like we've got an update for RetroArch, so let's go ahead and get that. And there it is. We're now up to date with RetroArch, and because we've just installed Dolphin, it's already up to date. But this is really awesome. The manage emulator section is brand new. It used to be known as manage RetroArch. But since we're integrating more and more, we have renamed it. It just makes it really easy to keep all of your emulators up to date. Another big new change for this version of LaunchBox for Android is the ability to manage your Android apps a lot better. From my Android section, you can see I've just got a bunch of games installed here. Now from our drop-down, we can actually manage apps directly from here, or we can head into the settings and do it. We can manually disable apps, or from the top here, all or none. Or we can only use the apps marked as games. So that's going to give us just a cleaner look here. It's not going to be jumbled up with all of the apps you're just not going to be launching through LaunchBox on Android. So now I've just got access to all of my Android games, and we can go ahead and start them up from here. And just to give you an idea here, if I was to go to manage apps and just hide all of them, now when we go back to our main menu, our Android section is going to be gone. So in order to re-enable it, from our drop-down, options, make sure show Android apps is enabled, manage Android apps, and we're back to that same page from the settings. We can also add new Android apps on startup, and I've got this setup just marked as games, so if I download a new game, it's going to automatically find that for me and put it in its correct location. If you want to go with all of your apps, you could always do that, but I've just got mine set up for marked as games, so when I download something new, it's going to be there ready for me to go. So with this new change, LaunchBox manages Android apps much, much better. Another new feature we've added to this version of LaunchBox for Android is the ability to use a custom emulator with code. So what this means is if we don't support a certain emulator that you've been wanting to use in LaunchBox for Android, and that emulator has built-in front-end support, you can add that emulator with code. Now, I do want to mention that we do cover a lot of the emulators in Android right now. So for instance, we'll go to Game Boy here, emulator settings, default emulator, I'm using RetroArch, but if you look down the list here, Old Boy Light, GBCoid, GBC.emu. So we've got a lot of emulators covered in Android, but if you do run across an emulator that you want to use and it hasn't been added to LaunchBox yet, and this is across the board with any emulator, we've got the custom emulator with code. And basically what we're going to do is set up our custom launch arguments right here. So if you know how to launch that specific emulator, we can input the code here. So for instance, like Pizza Boy, which we already support, this is just an example. You can verify the configuration and you can open up the custom emulator with code directly from here. And again, this was just an example because we do have a lot of the Android emulators covered here. It's just another feature that you can use if you run across something that hasn't been added to LaunchBox for Android just yet. And the final thing I wanted to talk about here was LaunchBox for Android now supports MelonDS. You can actually use the nightly if you want to. But if you check out the Play Store, it's in early access. And just to give you a look here, and MelonDS nightly. So if you want to use that emulator, you're more than welcome to. LaunchBox now fully supports it and its nightly version. We hope you enjoyed this new LaunchBox for Android. We've always got new features and fixes coming. If you're interested in checking out everything that's changed with 1.15 on Android, I'll leave a link to the changelog in the description. But that's going to wrap it up for this video. And like always, thanks for watching.